Hello everyone! This tutorial will tell you about the response effects in interactive animations. Response effect is essential in games, e-learning courses, and other types of interactive content. This is a fighting fruits game. For each question, you have to click to select a correct fruit. If your answer is right, you get a green tick. If not, you get a red cross. There's also sound effect in each response. Basically, the responses here are symbols. Initially, you make them invisible with a display of keyframes. Then, when you click the fruits, the mouse click event occurs to call and run them. So let's see how I create these responses. First, create symbols for the correct and incorrect responses. From the resources pane, insert the tick and cross image it into a scene. Then, right-click the tick and select convert to symbol. Name the new symbol correct response. And remember to clear the create playback checkbox because we will handle the playback later. Double-click the symbol to edit it. As the tick appears after a click of fruit for just some seconds, animate its display property. In the properties pane, add a display on keyframe. Change the playhead position and add a display off keyframe. Then, insert a sound effect for the correct response. Remember to uncheck the controls checkbox to turn player controls off. Then, click Add Playback. Select Start to play the audio. Move on to the incorrect response. Create the incorrect response symbol. Now we have two symbols for the right and wrong responses. For this question, there are one right answer and two wrong answers. So copy and paste the wrong response to add another response for the potato. Initially, all the responses are invisible, so add a display of keyframe to all of them. Now we will handle the interactivity. Right-click a carrot and select Event Handlers. For the mouse click event, apart from existing actions, add two new actions to call and run the correct response symbol. First, display the symbol element because it's currently invisible. Double-click the target cell and choose correct response symbol. Then use the start symbol actions to play it. For the apricot and potato, do the same steps to call the incorrect response symbol. So that's about response effects in interactive animations. See you in the next tutorial and bye for now.